distinguished TV medical expert and former U.S. Surgeon General Dr. Jerome Adams. I want to start with this news of Damar Hamlin. Can you explain to us exactly what comitia cordis is?
Well, great news that Damar Hamlin is on his way back and got cleared. I want to remind everyone that he had a cardiac arrest. When your heart stops beating on the football field on national TV, as we were all watching, commotio cordis is when you get a blunt hit to your chest. It happens a lot to hockey players, occasionally to football or baseball players, at just the exact wrong time that causes you to have an arrhythmia, which can then precipitate cardiac arrest. That's what happened to Damar Hamlin, and his life was saved because he received prompt CPR. So I think the lesson here to everyone is that the more we can help people understand that they all can do CPR, hands-only CPR, anyone can do it. You can teach an 11-year-old to do it. My daughter has been taught how to do it. The more we can give people like Damar Hamlin a chance to go on and live long and healthy lives.
Would you be worried as a parent about your son getting back on the field after what happened?
Well, that's a big question for all parents. Same question you have with Tua Tagovailoa, who had multiple concussions. Football is a dangerous sport. The good thing about this particular condition is, again, you saw that they had the capability to resuscitate him with CPR. So if my child wanted to play, this is not something I would be concerned about, provided there was the capability on the field for them to be resuscitated.
Okay, moving to a different health headline right now and what the White House calls an emerging threat. News 8 viewers heard this last week here on News 8 at 5. The mix of a veterinary tranquilizer and fentanyl. What is xylazine?
Drew, you mentioned it. This is a medication that we use to anesthetize animals. It's an animal tranquilizer, and it prolongs the high that people get from heroin and fentanyl use. The danger, though, is that it also increases the risk of overdose. And naloxone or Narcan, which we use to reverse fentanyl or heroin overdoses, doesn't reverse the effects of xylazine. Further, I've talked to many emergency medicine doctors, and they tell me that the injections of this animal tranquilizer lead to incredibly serious wounds, and many people have required amputations after using it.
Wow, there's a lot to worry about in all of that alone. So this marks the first time in history that a new administration has made the designation of an emerging threat since the category was created in 2019. What is the significance of this?
Well, for a drug to be categorized as an emerging threat, its use must have risen at least 15% in 3 out of 4 U.S. regions. 15%. Detection of xylazine in overdoses has actually increased 750% in the West, over 1,000% in the South, and more than 500% right here at home in the Midwest. So what this means is that the White House and the Office of National Drug Control Policy will now begin development of a national response plan that includes testing, treatment and support protocols, better data, and strategies to reduce illegal supply.
Okay, 1 minute left here. I want to turn to the most common sexually transmitted infection in the U.S., HPV. A new study shows that many people aren't even aware of it.
Yes. Big news today. That study, which is done annually, showed that in 2020, 70% were aware of the link between HPV and cervical cancer, and that represented a 7.4% drop from 2014. So fewer people are aware of the link between HPV and cancer, and only 30% knew that it could cause throat or anal cancers. And Drew, I want to finish on an important note here. The reason why this is such big news is because we have a vaccine that can prevent almost 100% of these cancers from occurring, the HPV vaccine. All of my kids have been vaccinated, but if people aren't aware that they can prevent cancer in their children, they're not going to get them vaccinated. And we're seeing vaccinations drop as this awareness level has dropped.
Okay. Dr. Jerome Adams, as always, we appreciate your time and insight.
Thank you. Get your kids vaccinated for HPV. You can get vaccinated up to age 45. You can prevent cancer.
Good stuff. Thanks so much.